Every day,
exactly.
Yeah,
I would have to say that it's very important.
I don't know.
How many votes was the mayor's race in Manchester decided by? Wasn't very many. I mean, there was even a recount done, right?
I don't know.
So, I mean, literally, I think it was like fives or tens of votes.
Out of how many votes they have in Manchester?
So, I mean, that's interesting if things are more tense or not. What I'm getting at is how we are interested in these people as far as what sort of authority are we granting each other. I think it's just absolutely absurd that there's a system of government that rules over individuals in such an extreme manner, that has mass taxation, not just on individual issues, but on the diversity of things we do in our lives. And it just seems very ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm Garrett Ian.
Oh, no kidding. Oh, we've talked before on the phone. Nick Lee.
Oh, okay. Nice to meet you, Nick.
It's, sorry, Ian is just E-A-N.
E-A-N, yep. Okay. And Garrett's two R's and one T. Okay.
You're living in Concord now, right?
Yeah, formerly of Ian. Well, I'm from Concord originally. I was living in
Eagle. I've been raised
there. Have you been to a bunch of different places yet?
This is my voting ward, so this is my first stop. I'll probably try to get to maybe two or three more today. But I think it's good because, like, there's a lot of foot traffic in this area and people coming through to actually, like, exercise. Voting is, like, emphasized as something that I think, like, they say it's so important. It's like, and a lot of people, I think, they neglect taking control of other areas of their life. So this is the one thing you're supposed to do in government. Like, I don't think they should be treated like that. Like, voting should be the most important thing. I think somebody could take time to go testify at the state house. Maybe that's important.
There are a lot of those
people. You were saying you like to see people just ignore it or not give it as much influence as it has, but doesn't that kind of let the influence run away from you then? You know what I mean? Like, if you just ignore it,
that's true to some extent. I'd say that's exemplified by what's going on in the presidential race this year. I mean, I think there's like an unprecedented level of disgust among the major political candidates. And I think that is like in part to so many people like being turned off to the system entirely. And yeah, there is an extent to which it does allow like some bad people to rise up. But at the same time, I think like it's kind of like a necessary like transition for something that is crumbling to kind of like, you know, have a spiral out of control like that. And I think that might be what we're seeing with the presidential campaign. It's like the candidates are worse because the people that have invested more and more time into it are like the smart, like I hate to put it publicly, like I think the smarter people kind of tuned out to it. And that's why the election process, at least for the presidential candidates, has been so much more lowest common denominator this season. And I think, I'd like to think that there's more focus on the like state level races because those I don't like advocate politics overall, but if you think of it, the state local races do more directly affect people. And that's kind of like what the message I'm saying, like, you know, the closer authority seems like it's less inherently impressive than more than the authority is the closest authority. So, I'm not advocating for local government, but like I'd rather see people turning towards
whether or not this agrees with your local people. The answer to that question for most people.
When somebody walks up to this message and goes to vote, what do you think is going through their mind? Do I change anything? How they act in there?
I like the link. So, there's a few times I've like candidates and I've like put their names out, like Ron Paul or something in the past. That's cool, but I don't feel like there's somebody running in this race that would like really get behind this primary. So I'd rather have my message be something that's more than what is the nature of like what you're doing here. I think it's there's a lot of because there's so much accolade and platitudes associated with voting that giving I think a counter message is important too, that it's like it's not as important and not as like much. And so just thinking about like what are you really doing? You really know, like you don't really know what you're doing a lot of times. Like people that are selecting people don't know what they support.
Like,
and like literally I just by checking them off, I just authorize them to vote. Maybe that's not such a good idea. If you know that someone you can trust and they're gonna help you out or something.
3 hours on a Saturday morning, you know, mid-March, when it's starting to get warm and sunny out.
Do you get a lot of comments?
The day buzzes.
I feel like the polling locations, like, yeah, I feel like there was a little bit more of, like, resistance to polling locations. But more recently, it's been more recognized some speech activity. What's funny is, in Keene, I actually experienced backlash for chalking, but it wasn't from authority. I don't know, like, if there seemed to be, like, kind of a perfect storm of people upset about things in Keene, and that may have spilled over to my chalking. But it seemed like the opposite. In Concord, my experience was, like, everybody seemed
to have a good day, guys.
That's probably like the next place I'd go to. But yeah, I think I will actually vote. I'm still undecided. decided as to whether or not I'd grab a Democratic ballot for the voters and which race I would influence.
I suppose, but they don't really.
It's like a Republican talking about the Democratic side and vice versa. I mean, if there's, yeah, you can raise any more than you want. A lot of people forget that. I think someone's not on the ballot.